Sunday, May 9th. It's been a little while since I posted a video. Not stopped work on the car, just been concentrating on different pieces. My engine block is still out. I actually pick it up tomorrow. It's completely bored out, but I still have to get the cylinder head bolt out. More on that another time. But I have a plan for that. Fingers crossed. In the meantime, I started to work on the front suspension now that the rear suspension is complete. And today I'm going to work on the front hub unit, which includes the upright. And I already have one stripped down, and I'm going to strip the other side down today. But in the meantime, I already completed the upper control arms, and I finished assembling them. Actually, yesterday. So let's take a quick look at those, and then I'll show you this front hub. So these clean up really, really, really well. They're obviously very dirty when you get them, and they're off the car. It's the front of the car. It collects all the shit, and they just get really oily and a lot of grease around them with the ball joints, etc. These washers, I still need to buy new ones. I forgot to order those when I was refurbishing everything. But basically, I've now got polypropylene bushes, which are stiffer, and I have a new ball joint, and everything is cleaned up and ready to assemble on the car. So I have both sides, left and right. Complete. This is the front unit with the upright brake assembly attached to it. I'm going to basically strip this down today and start the cleanup process for this. It's interesting that Jaguar used a lot of aluminium. You got to bear in mind, this is basically a 60s car, and they're using aluminium quite extensively. So this is the upright off the other side that had its first level of cleaning, and this is what it looks like without the cleaning. So, it's just gonna, everything cleans up immensely well.
Thank you.
Saturday, May 15th, last week I managed to strip the front hubs and also had a day of cleaning them. One or two issues came up, and let's actually take a look. So the big thing that happened was that I could not get this, could not get that nut off. And regardless of how much heat I put on it anyway, so eventually turning on it and the actual shaft sheared. So fortunately I was able to get brand new ones, and I decided to go for a brand new pair, so I have one for the left and for the right. I've done an initial clean of this upright. You can see it's aluminium, and this is going to clean up really nicely. There's some ball joint damage in the cup here, which I'm not quite sure where that's come from. I'm hoping that I didn't do that when I separated the ball joint when it was actually on the car. I don't think so, but you never know. Normally you separate them at the top of the bolt. So, I have to tidy that up. Now, what I did do was that there's several options on a new ball joint. This is the one that came out. This is the ball. This is the cup at the bottom. This shim is a spacer. Then they have lock tabs, four bolts securing it in. And then all of that is replaced by a self-contained, self-sealed unit. So literally it's this part, and this part replaces all of these. So this requires a little bit of fiddling to get it to go in, but other than that, it's a direct replacement. So I'm going to give those a try. I have new brake calipers new brake pads, new bolts. I have brand new bearings to replace the new, these are the new ones. These are the old ones. I'll refurbish this drive unit spline. I haven't been able to find these online, so I'm actually going to refurbish these. They'll again, when I've done with the cleaning of all of these, they'll come out great. They're a bit rusty, but other than that, and a bit unloved, other than that, everything looks good. So another day of cleaning, some painting this week, and then I will I'll do the assembly next week. Looking good. Saturday, May 22nd, front hub assembly day. So the last couple of weeks I've been cleaning up the front hubs, and today I get to put them together. So I'll show you the parts, and I've already done one as a practice run, and let me show you what that looks like, and then I'll talk through the parts and some of the things that I've done since the previous video. So this is a fully assembled unit, factory fresh. It's a good friend of mine, Hubert, has just said they look factory fresh. Yes, it does. So I have all of the individual parts. I have new bearings. I've completely cleaned the hub unit itself. Spent quite a bit of time with that. I have new brake pads, a ball joint. I've gone with the seal ball joint for the bottom. Brake line. All of the brake panel. Brake guard, splash guard, weather guard, I don't know what they call that. Anyway, I couldn't find new ones, so I repaired the old ones. And stub axle is all cleaned up. Spent quite a bit of time getting that ready for assembly. New stub axle and steering arm and brake disc. And then the first job I've got will be to put the pads in, the new brake caliper. So getting there, one bit at a time. We'll see how we get on. Both units are assembled. They don't take long to assemble, but they take a long time to disassemble, clean, make sure they all go back together. So it's very rewarding. They look absolutely amazing. So I'm super thrilled.